Today, let's talk about napkin rings. Yes, the ones which hold napkins. But in a different perspective. In geometry, the napkin ring problem involves finding the volume of a band of specified height around a sphere. That is, the part that remains after a hole in the shape of a circular cylinder is drilled through the center of the sphere. If you draw a sphere, that is, remove a cylinder from it, you'll be left with a shape called a napkin ring. It's a bizarre shape. Because, if two napkin rings have the same height, well, they'll have the same volume, regardless of the size of the spheres they came from. Cool. It is a counterintuitive fact that this volume does not depend on the original sphere's radius, but only on the resulting band's height. The small sphere has a smaller circumference than the big sphere, which means less volume, but its ring is thicker, which means more volume. Both of those effects exactly cancel out. So these two napkin rings have identical volumes. That is, they take up the same amount of space. The volume of the napkin ring does not depend upon the radius of the sphere, but only on the height of the cylinder. To see why the napkin ring problem is true, let's discuss Cavalieri's principle. Cavalieri's principle states that in case of two dimensions, suppose two regions in a plane are included between two parallel lines in that plane. If every line parallel to these two lines intersects both regions in line segments of equal length, then the two regions have equal areas. In case of three dimensions, suppose two regions in three space, that is, two solids, are included between two parallel planes. If every plane parallel to these two planes intersects both regions in cross sections of equal area, then the two regions have equal volumes. In simple terms, it states that for any two solids sandwiched between parallel planes, if any other parallel plane intersects both in regions of equal area, no matter where it's taken from, well then, the solids have the same volume. Now, let's apply Cavalieri's principle to napkin rings. We can see that two napkin rings with similar heights have identical volumes by showing that, when cut by a plane, the area of one's cross-section always equals the area of the other's. Now, to do this, notice that the area of the sphere's cross-section minus the area of the cylinder's cross-section gives us the area of the napkin ring's cross-section. Depending on where we slice the napkin rings, the cross sections will have different areas, but they will always be the same as each other. But what does this mean for you? For life in the universe? Well, as we know, if you like it, you should put a ring on it. But if you